about $150.
Any other girls? Okay, back here.
I thought she looked so proud of her prize. So I have, what a prize, a great gray owl in my own arms. He did not like being caught or banded, but what a great opportunity in the name of science. Some may say that traumatizing the bird is not good. However, the information gathered will help learn more about their species, and I was part of that today. Being captured and banded probably didn't make the owl's day, but it certainly made my day. What cold.
How many people can say they have cuddled a great gray? I just love being out in this cold, crisp day. Quick, snap my picture before he flies away.
And finally,
the bowl.
Who had the bowl? Who would like to share? In the back.
I have the makings of a bobcat. 4 fast feet, radar whiskers, perpetually sharp incisors, see forever day night eyes, hear whisper ears, and I can get into tight places. Sadly though, I stand only 1.5 inches tall, so all sorts of things pick on me, even pick me up, and I rarely see them coming. It isn't easy being the guy at the bottom, holding up the food pyramid for those flighty creatures.
Another bowl? Okay.
Minding my own business, gnawing some hosta tubers, a great shadow quickly blacked out the sun. I scurried across the road towards a speeding car. The car knocked the shadow out of the sky just as a sharp pine scratched my neck. So to celebrate my narrow escape, I headed back to the hosta patch to gnaw some more.
People were actually going to Walmart buying white mice and throwing them out so they can photograph the owls.
Oh, wow. Do you want to share yours, Gary? Okay. Where did you put it?
Our first day away from the nest, and I haven't seen my sister for a while, but this tastes so good. I'll stay here until I'm done. I wonder what that flapping noise was.
We do this for every class, and it's amazing, the bowl just always, you know, uncle is gone, sister is missing. Ready, I am ready. Final one now. Oh yeah, didn't announce, he's doing his penance again.
I did it again. Can't say that I don't feel bad.
There's a couple of people who keep signing prices on her time. They just
As Natalie Goldberg says, if you ever write without ever reading other authors, you're writing in a vacuum. The other half of writing is reading. I don't know if you noticed, but I gave you a lot of references. I was always showing you books. I read a lot, I'm always finding things in books for my wish I had said that, and I truly believe that you must, in order to write well, you must read. And so I thought then, as what we call then the next step, is writing from a quote. That's taking your notes, maybe you're going to be writing an article now, or you're going to be writing something, and you just can't get started. What do you do? Well, usually what I like to do is I'll use a beginning quote for inspiration. Sometimes I won't even include that quote, but you look at it, you find it, and then, for at least me, things start to happen. When we were writing our book, Illinois Wilds, I used a lot of quotes from early pioneers. This one is from Eliza Steele. She wonderfully describes the Tallgrass Prairie. Over here, I have his name. Oh, Henry Allen Gleason, a hero of mine. He did a lot of work here in the Sand Ridge area. In fact, there's a nature preserve named after Henry Allen Gleason, and this is what he calls Devil's Neck. So I began this chapter, and we began this chapter with quotes, but it also helps to set the tone. I've had to write about periodical cicadas. I believe next year we figured out should be an emergence of periodical cicadas. How do you write about them? Well, let's have somebody who's talked about an emergence of periodical cicadas. Kind of gives a little bit of a description. And sometimes if you don't feel comfortable writing about this topic, well, you've had an expert and maybe they, you know, they'll lend a little bit of credibility to what you're saying. So I just thought this was a nice description of the cicadas. Here I use my own notes. I wrote about the spiny soft-shell turtle. I found one day crossing the highway, so I talk about picking it up. I didn't realize until later that they do bite. I mean, I had it in the car by my feet, and nothing happened, but they do bite. And someone said, well, you realize they bite. No, but it felt like a patent leather purse. It was so cool. Where might you find some of these sources? I gave you Paul Engel's book, wonderful for pioneer quotes. Like I said, your own notes, your own readings. You'll notice that I gave you the Illinois Steward. If you like, you can turn on the lights. And in the Steward, this Steward with the icicle, first of all, I'm supposed to remind you that this was the Illinois Steward that was devoted entirely to climate issues. So it's all about climate change in Illinois. But it also, I used the beginning quote for an article I wrote, which was about the Dudley Sisters. The Dudley Sisters was an exhibit that was here at Emicon for a while. It's a piece of these.
Dixon Mounds.
Oh, it was at Dixon Mounds.
The CK.
But anyway, it's owned by the Illinois State Museum. It's just a wonderful exhibit, and right now we have it at the Illinois Natural History Survey. But I used something from Peter Matheson, which is The Being of the Place, The Poem of the Place, and then I titled the article, A Poem of Place, The Dudley Sisters. The Dudley Sisters were quite unique in which they basically taught themselves how to draw. They, in the early 1900s, they had a how-to drawing class. They did this, and they just did wonderful paintings and drawings of wildflowers that they found around their home, which was in the Quincy area. And it's just a wonderful documentation. They do have some notes, so I thought the reason I gave everybody the magazine is I also thought you might enjoy just another take on communicating nature. So I figure we've got to have not an assignment, since we're not meeting anymore in the future. So what are we going to do? I'd like you to write from a quote. So I brought an object in. You'll come up, take a look at the object, and then I have some quotes that you can pick up. I would like you to use one of these quotes as you write about the object.
Or a piece of the quote.
A piece of the quote. Somehow you have to use one of the quotes as you write about the object. This is a passenger pigeon, just in case you didn't know. But other than that, it's up to you. You have, again, I'll give you until 2 o'clock, so you have 10 minutes. And so come on up, take a look at the pigeon, get your sheet of quotes.